It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Strategist of Payne Capital Management. 1 month ago, the S&P 500 hit an all-time record high on February 19th. It has now fallen close to 30%. A month ago, if someone had told you that millions of people would soon be quarantined in their homes, hoarding toilet paper, that profitable businesses would be forced to close their doors, and huge revenue-generating events like the Masters, the Kentucky Derby, the NBA, the NHL, and my annual favorite, March Madness, would all be canceled, most would have thought you insane. Actually, what we're experiencing right now truly is March Madness. We are truly living through market history. Now, a lot of damage has been done to the market and has been caused by forced selling by speculators who couldn't meet their margin calls, by hedge funds unwinding failed risk strategies, and by the same panicked retail investors who simply sold everything, as they usually do in every correction. Good news, though, is that central banks and governments across the globe have already taken drastic stimulus measures to hopefully soften the blow. Just 1 week after announcing $50 billion worth of help, the British government announced an additional $350 billion of loans and tax relief this week. France and Germany have also unleashed billions of fiscal stimulus. Federal Reserve is doing their part, and our government is proposing $1 trillion worth of tax credits for businesses impeded by the current crisis. Now, none of these measures, however, can force the coronavirus to stop spreading. And only when the virus fades will life start returning to normal. So the actions taken by the various governments are important, but these stimulus measures most likely will not bear fruit until months after businesses reopen and life gets back to normal. See, here's the good news. Market cycles turn with or without stimulus. Stock markets are forward-looking and move in advance of economic data. And bull markets have begun long before economic data improved. The last bull market began in March of 2009, when things were and felt horrible. Unemployment and bankruptcies were rising, and the global economy was still contracting. The recession, however, ended a full 5 months after the stock market had already bottomed. See, stocks don't wait for improved data. Needless to say, all bear markets in history have been buying opportunities, and every investor I have ever met loves a buying opportunity. However, every time in my career when a buying opportunity presents itself, they all say the same thing. Hey, Bob, I wanted a buying opportunity, but not when the news is so scary. Truth be told, you never get good prices in stocks with good news. Low prices and scary headlines comes with the territory. See, what we need to do today is to look over the valley and realize this crisis too will pass. It's not a time to be a hero or a victim with your portfolio. It's critical to stay invested and to maintain the asset allocation in your portfolio that will allow you to weather the storm, but also to reap the rewards and thrive in the rebound when it comes. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, you know what, I need a portfolio that's appropriate to my goals, to my risk tolerance in this volatile time. You know, my son Ryan and I have 75 years of combined industry experience of building low-cost, tax-efficient, goal-based portfolios. All you need to do is text or call 844-752-6692. That's 844-752-6692. Or simply call 844-PLAN-NYC. That's 844-PLAN-NYC. Hey, this is Bob Payne, and I'm the Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management.